Hello friends, welcome to ProTalent and I am Nitin Parmar. I welcome you all for this very important current affair module. We are discussing about antitrust suit against Facebook. So, what is this issue all about? This issue will help us to understand what do we mean by antitrust law, what are the previous instances of antitrust law, why antitrust laws are needed, what are the goals of this antitrust laws, and more importantly, do we have any experiences of this in our country called India? Let's start to talk about this antitrust suit. Now, why was it in the news? Because US federal government and few other state governments, to the tune of some around 48 states, have sued Facebook for illegally crushing the competition. So you may ask, how Facebook has crushed the competition? So as in when new competitive product is coming, Facebook goes and acquires it. This is how they remove competition. The lawsuit filed has put under the scanner the entire Facebook related part, their merger acquisition related things. Okay, so there was earlier case of Microsoft. Look at the data. In late 1990s, Microsoft's MS Office had 90% market share, while their new products like internet browser, they had only 44% of market share, while operating system had only 36% of market share. So they adopted a pricing policy that prevents entry of a new player. So if you purchase MS Office, we will be giving you internet Explorer as well as Windows operating system free of cost. So thereby what will happen? People will not go to a new browser, people will not purchase new operating system, because anyway they are going to get it freely, because they are one of the product which is called MS Office turned out to be very successful. I hope you are getting the idea. So let's understand what is this antitrust law, or popularly known as anti-competition law. Okay, good. So the goal of this law is to provide an equal playing field for similar businesses, so that one giant firm cannot eat away other small fishes. Yes or no? I hope you are able to understand this. Very good. So primarily, it is stopping businesses from playing dirty in the businesses. I hope it is very clear. This is also known as competition law, and they are also known as antitrust laws. Okay. Now, in what are the various, scenario if antitrust laws are not there? If antitrust laws are not there, customers like you and me will face a lot of problem. We don't have a lot of options. We will not have a lot of choices. Okay. If we don't have a lot of competition, we are bound to pay more money. We are bound to get lower quality product. We are bound to accept only limited products. I hope you are able to understand this. So consumers would be forced to pay higher prices and would have access to limited supply of products and services. So thereby, antitrust laws are very crucial. Okay, these are very crucial. So for example, in India, we have Competition Commission of India. Do you understand this? CCI. In India, when CCI was established, one of the initial cases came was from Bollywood movie. Okay, when a very big budget movie called Ek Tha Tiger was released, the Yash Raj Films, which is basically a producer and distributors, they told to all single theaters that if you are taking Ek Tha Tiger, you must be, it came in the Eid month, matlab Eid ke samay pe wo release hua tha, and they had another movie which was going to come, which is called Jab Tak Hai Jaan, which was a Diwali release. Okay, they said if you want Ek Tha Tiger, okay, which was bound to get success because it was a big budget movie. Okay, and they said ki if you are taking Ek Tha Tiger, you must take Jab Tak Hai Jaan on Diwali. If you are not taking Ek Tha Tiger and you want Jab Tak Hai Jaan, we will not give you. Okay, we will not give you, you only Ek Tha Tiger. We are bundling this. Okay, now at that point in time in the Diwali month, Ajay Devgan wanted to release a movie called Son of Sardar. Okay, now he was not getting those theaters, single screen theaters were not available. Okay, even to the tune of, you can say, Yashraj Film worked to the tune of very, you can say, high level of competition. They said that all multi-screen theaters must also give all screens to Jab Tak Hai Jaan, because that was the last movie by Yash Chopra. Okay, so this is how the competition is curtailed or stopped at various stages. To understand all these details, we have to go by every industry, every business. We have to understand the modus operandi of business, identify how businesses work, what kind of, you can say, connections are getting developed between businesses. This kind of information has to be learned. So, if we talk about the guiding principle for this antitrust law, is identifying appreciable adverse effect on competition. Okay. If we are able to identify appreciable adverse effect on competition, possibly we can identify the action of a company which is antitrust and anti-competitive or not. So, what are the factors? One, whether it is creating barriers to new entrant in the market. How do they create barriers to, you can say, enter in the market? Okay. They are trying to raise the bar of spending a lot of money on advertisements or not allowing few other players to enter. Okay, so for example, Facebook. Facebook says on Facebook, the APIs, okay, the applications of various other players cannot be provided. Facebook is a social media. On a social media, if I want to share something from Twitter or from few other sources, it becomes difficult because Facebook doesn't allow that. Okay, now that is how they restrict the new, you can say, entrant. Okay, driving existing competitors out of the market. How do they do that? Possibly they can purchase them. Okay, or possibly they spend a lot of money on, you can say, certain things, thereby new players cannot come. Okay, foreclosure of competition by hindering their entry into the market, or they are giving so much of benefit to consumers which is free of cost, okay, or at a very low price that other players cannot manage. So if you know, when Jio wanted to enter, Reliance Jio wanted to enter into telecom market, they gave free internet for a lot of time period. Yes or no? So this longer time period, if they are providing free internet, they are not charging money, that means there is a problem that other people cannot enter. Or you can say, sometimes they say that such kind of, you can say, activities, are they having appreciable impact on growing competition? Quality is improving. Okay, so at the name of quality, at the name of going to the consumers, companies try and stop competitors. So the antitrust laws, or the CCI, like in India, that is Competition Commission of India's, their work is to ensure that the competition is flourishing, but not at the expense of consumers. Consumers must get right competition. I hope it is clear. Very good. So what are the various methods? I just discussed those methods. I will repeat one more time. Market allocation. For example, let us say Coca-Cola and Pepsi, they are dominant player in the soft drink market. Let us say Coca-Cola says to Pepsi that northern region is mine, southern region is yours. Okay, hypothetically. Okay, so if they are trying to enter in this kind of allocation, which is also known as cartelization. Okay, okay. So cartelization may happen on many things. Okay, this is one example. So this market allocation will stop other players to enter. Okay, and possibly if the northern region is with Coca-Cola and southern region is with Pepsi, they are not competing with each other, they may possibly increase prices. So who will face problem? You and I. Okay, bid rigging. So when there are auctions happening, okay, when there are auctions happening, so there are few players, they come together and they say, if we want to allow one of us to win the bid, what we need to ensure is either all of us agree to provide a lower bid or a very higher bid, whatever is the circumstance. So this is called bid rigging, either increasing bid too much or decreasing the bid too much so that the one of the party will benefit. Price fixing, the fixed price. Okay, for example, in international forum there is a organization called OPEC, that is oil producing and exporting countries. They come together, they form cartelization and they decide that this is a price. So they fix a price. So when they fix a price, okay, it is so high that apart from them, there is no other, you can say, provider, or there is no other producer will give us oil. So we have to pay such a high price. Okay, I hope you are able to understand this. Or they create monopolies. So in this sector, they are the monopoly. In fact, for Facebook, the charge is exactly the same, called monopolies. They are creating monopolies by acquiring Instagram, by acquiring WhatsApp. How? I will explain in a few minutes. So by acquiring merger acquisition, so by doing merger acquisition, they may create monopoly, or they may create market allocation, or whatever. So these are the ways to affect free market. Okay, so that the new players are not allowed to enter, and thereby competition is only in the limited people's hand, and that is against consumers. So I hope this idea is very clear. Let's talk about now Facebook case. So US Federal Trade Commission, remember, there are three or four antitrust bodies in America. One of them is Federal Trade Commission. They had a lawsuit against Facebook. They accused Facebook for eliminating competition with acquisition. Remember, this acquisition of Instagram and Facebook and WhatsApp was already approved by FTC itself, and they themselves filed case against Facebook. Okay, FTC has alleged the Facebook that it is illegally maintaining its personal social networking monopoly through year-long course of anti-competitive product. So they developed many anti-competitive products. Okay, so they are, now what do we mean by anti-competitive product? The product which you are bringing that will create monopolies, that is called anti-competitive product. Okay, I hope it is clear. So in 2012, Facebook acquired Instagram at merely $1 billion, and in 2014 they acquired WhatsApp at whooping $19 billion. Okay, and they are basically acquired to, you can say, remove competition, but it is illegal. That is how the accusation is. Why it is illegal? Just a minute, I will explain that. FTC has also accused Facebook of imposing anti-competitive conditions on the software developers. So if you are software developer, you are working with Facebook and you would like to provide certain benefits to Facebook, you are allowed. But if you are providing cross products, so coming from Twitter, you want to transfer that, you can say, link to Facebook, that is not possible. Okay, so I'm sure you understand the Facebook platform is not just Facebook's platform. there are a lot of other, you can say, software companies are taking the benefit of this, you can say, platform of Facebook, and they are using a lot of services of the Facebook. Okay, I hope it is very clear. So for example, on your website you are putting a button called Facebook. Aap wahan se seedha share kar sakte ho. So there is API is needed. Aap wahan pe click karoge to wo seedhi link Facebook ke dwara aapke account ke upar share ho jayegi. So those kind of things are going to come. So Facebook restricted third party software developers access to valuable interconnections to their platform. So they stopped third party software developer. Okay, so for example, Facebook is doing something on their own, that is acceptable. If someone is working exclusively with Facebook, that is acceptable. But if someone is working with Twitter's short video app Vine, okay, from there you are sharing something on Facebook, that is not acceptable. So what is the full form of API? Application Programming Interface. So this API is a very crucial thing, okay, for managing all this technology stuff, because API allows people to have application programming interface. So for example, let us say I want to access certain application. I put that application on my site, okay. So that is how the application programming interface is possible, okay. From, for example, let's say when you join protalentdigital.com, there is a kind of SMS coming to you for verification purpose. Okay, SMS coming to your mobile number, registered mobile number. So there is API provided. Our website uses that API, and we integrate that API with our service provider of SMS delivery. Okay, I hope it is very clear. Very good. In all, FTC says Facebook's practices have harmed competition, left consumers with very limited choices, and deprived advertisers of the benefits of competition. In fact, these are very serious charges, and these charges may result into division of Facebook. Okay, let's see what are the various, you can say, details. For example, FTC said that when Facebook acquired Instagram, at that time people were shifting from desktop computers to smartphones, and thereby they were increasingly embracing themselves to photo sharing. Okay, Facebook quickly recognized this issue, and thereby they actually acquired, you can say, this Instagram. By acquiring it, they removed competition from Instagram, and thereby their power of monopoly has increased. I hope it is clear. Very good. Okay, so they also tried to purchase Snapchat, because Snapchat was becoming very successful. Okay, now why Snapchat was becoming successful? Because there was a popular feature in Snapchat called Stories. Now that Stories were becoming very popular. Facebook wanted to purchase it. They couldn't purchase it. Now they put that feature into the Instagram. Is this comfortable? Very good. Now let's talk about WhatsApp. FTC said Facebook did the same thing with WhatsApp. WhatsApp was a clear global category leader in the mobile messaging. In the mobile messaging industry, okay, WhatsApp is a clear winner. Okay, they notes that Facebook acquired WhatsApp, that means all future threat will have a more difficult time gaining scale up in the mobile messaging. So when they acquired WhatsApp, any new entrant who wishes to enter, they require more time, lot of time, to reach to this scale of WhatsApp. By acquiring, Facebook gets this, you can say, power. Okay, WhatsApp dominates mobile messaging space. Currently it has 2 billion users globally. Alone in India it has 400 million users. Okay, there is no other messaging app that come to even close of it. The second, you can say, position pe aane wala hai, that is Facebook ka apna मैसेंजर, ठीक है. सो इंस्टा एंड व्हाट्सएप आर टू प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर मोर अपीलिंग टू यंग यूजर्स एंड दैट टू इन न्यू ज्योग्राफीज एंड देयरफॉर दे आर क्रूशियल टू ड्राइविंग फेसबुक कंपनीज ग्रोथ. नाउ कंपनी के लिए ये अच्छी बात है, बट वेन कंपनी यूजेस ऑल दिस फॉर देयर ओन मोनोपोली देन इट इज नॉट गुड फॉर कस्टमर्स एंड देयर बाय दे हैव टू बी ब्रोकन. ओके, आई होप इट इज वेरी क्लियर. वेरी गुड. सो वॉट इज द एम ऑफ एफ टी सी लॉ सूट? उनका एम क्या है? देयर एम इज दैट दे आर चैलेंजिंग दिस अप्रूव्ड ट्रांजेक्शन बिकॉज दे आर वायलेटिंग लॉ. दे से एक्शन चैलेंजेस मोर देन जस्ट द एक्विजिशन. सो वी आर नॉट चैलेंजिंग मियरली एन एक्विजिशन बट द एक्शंस डिराइविंग आउट ऑफ एक्विजिशंस, दैट इज व्हाट वी आर चैलेंजिंग. द एम इज नाउ टू रोल बैक फेसबुक्स एंटी कंपिटिटिव कंडक्ट and restore competition, so possibly they may go to the level of divestitures of assets of Insta and WhatsApp, which means they may possibly require to resell Insta and WhatsApp to few other people. Okay, so that the social media platform of Facebook is very different, WhatsApp becomes very different, and Insta becomes very different. Okay, I hope it is very clear. So Facebook might be forced to sell this. FTC also wants to prohibit Facebook from imposing anti-competitive conditions on the software developer. So, if you are a software developer and you are not allowed to, you can say, transfer a lot of connections, so that is not acceptable. So, Facebook ko force kiya jayega that other software developers should be allowed to put data on their website. So this means Facebook will have to seek prior permission of FTC while acquiring few other companies in future. So what is the response by Facebook, which is very obvious? Facebook has to respond. Facebook says our competition is with Apple, Google, Twitter, you can say Amazon, TikTok, Microsoft. We are not doing anything wrong with those people. It said the lawsuit also ignored the fact that the users could and did move often to competitive apps. Yes or no? So if they want to move to few other competitive apps, they are free to do that. We are not forcing on them. Now that looks appropriate, but we have to understand that the scale at which Facebook is working. Okay. Now, for example, you and I would like to shift from Facebook to other platform. Is there a possibility? No. Why? Because all our friends, all our relatives, all our known people are on Facebook and on Insta and on WhatsApp. Okay. How can we shift to other platform? It is really becoming very difficult. Okay. So, Facebook also questioned the attack on its acquisition. They said that FTC had cleared Insta deal after an in-depth review. WhatsApp transaction had been reviewed by European Union and they did not find any problem. So why are you doing it now is the challenge which you can say Facebook is providing. It said FTC has seemingly no regard for settled law. So what is a settled law? Once you have already given approval, why are you bringing it back? Okay. Or consequences to innovation and investment. So when we have invested heavily on Insta, on WhatsApp, okay, so there are a lot of consequences of that. We may possibly gain monopoly out of it because of our investment, because of our innovation, and thereby Facebook, you can say, accused FTC to do this idea of revisionist history. You are revising a lot of things. Okay, you are doing a revision and which is not acceptable. Okay, antitrust laws are supposed to work and those hard challenges are best solved by updating rules of the internet. Okay, but there is no other way to be done this. So API restrictions, what we are doing is we have a right to choose our business partner. So this is really okay. Now look at this entire idea. What I understand is Facebook's arguments holds true to a reasonable level, but something more than that. Something more than that is the way they have created monopoly on social media. Okay, whether it is through Insta or WhatsApp or let's say Facebook, their monopoly is so high that you and I do not have any other choice for social media. And therefore, this antitrust law should be, you can say, should ensure that Facebook should be divided. I hope it is very clear to everyone. Sabko baatein samajh mein aayi. You decide whether Facebook is appropriate or not in doing this, or you can say, should we stop Facebook in dividing all this? Okay, so my dear students, this session must have given you detailed explanation about this antitrust law. You must have enjoyed learning it. More importantly, आपने इससे अगर कुछ भी सीखा है, प्लीज इस वीडियो को लाइक करिए, हमारे चैनल को शेयर करिए एंड शेयर इट टू लार्ज नंबर ऑफ पीपल टू बी पार्ट ऑफ प्रो टैलेंट. ओके, यू गेट दिस पीडीएफ फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑन protalentdigital.com. ओके, थैंक यू एंड ऑल द बेस्ट.